heard a lot of talking about disunity. That disunity is coming about because we don't have a center of gravity. And that center of gravity is the Southern Cameroon Defense Forces. And Southern Cameroon Defense Forces will be there to protect our entire people, all our political factions, all our members of the consortium, all the members of SCACOF, and Southern Cameroon Defense Forces will do its possible best to secure the resources of our homeland for our children and for all the generations to come after us. So, we are gonna be asking one simple question. Our individual and collective obligation within this struggle. Now, before you fight for your nation, you have your personal life, you have your family, you have your job, and it's out of your job that you take care of your children, your wife, your kids, and all that. Now, the struggle has come. You sit by yourself and ask yourself, how do I engage in this struggle without jeopardizing my family, my job? Now, that's a question that only you can answer. The struggle cannot answer you that question. So, your answer is a private answer. You have to find yourself a place to anchor within the struggle. As I said, not everybody can be a politician. Not everybody can be a military person. Not everybody can be a nurse for the wounded soldier. Not everybody can be a farmer to plant food for the Republic. But everybody have something that they can do to help the cause. And you don't have to be asked to contribute. You don't have to be drafted to contribute. You go to where you can contribute and give in your contribution. We all have to be proactive. I came into the struggle out of my own personal choice. And my choice was after the first videos came out in Boya with our kids being brutalized. And I have a good life. But I decided, if I have a good life and I'm watching television or I'm on social media watching my brothers and sisters being brutalized, being my sisters being raped, the condition back home, and the food that I'm eating or the vacation that I take, I can't even enjoy it anymore because in the back of my head, I may be a foreign citizen by nationality, but I'm of Cameroonian, Southern Cameroonian birth by nature. So I will never live in peace within myself if I don't contribute the best that I know. And the best that I know, I did not hide it. The best that I know is to pick up a rifle, gang up with the good brothers, and say, enough is enough. We are going to protect our sisters from rape. We are going to secure the natural resources for our sons. And we are going to live as dignified people once again. This route is not for every Southern Cameroonian. But this route is not the most important route. All the routes are important equally. Because I saw what my brothers and sisters did within the consortium. That was a marvelous job they did. I saw my brothers in Morris did a marvelous job in mobilizing the people out there as recently as yesterday in New York. Everybody have something to contribute. It doesn't matter how small it is. It's important to the struggle. So we are asking, pleading with all Southern Cameroonians around the world. We have a job to do. This struggle has been internationalized, but at best, this struggle is a struggle that we ourselves in the diaspora have to be ready to take it back to Cameroon and save our people and homeland. So, the globalization of it has taken place, and the diaspora has assumed responsibility to power the struggle on. But the diaspora should also understand, as educated as we in the diaspora and financial resources are a little bit easier for us, we have competent, educated young brothers and sisters back home who are trapped in the quagmire that is happening there at this very moment. We also have to take into consideration that the leaders of tomorrow are not only residing in the diaspora, but all villages inside Southern Cameroon, all cities inside Southern Cameroon, the leaders are there. We don't know them. So our march going forward as Southern Cameroon Defense Forces, if we identify a young Southern Cameroonian in the villages in northwest or southwest region of our country, if these Southern Cameroonians have capacity in the political arena, we will direct them to the politicians in this struggle. If these Southern Cameroonians have the capacity to be in the military, I assure you Southern Cameroonians, we would like to keep them for ourselves. Because we are there for military. If we find a military boy, a military girl, willing to serve, willing to duty for homeland, we will keep them. If we find a brother who is an intellectual from Bamenda University or from Boya University, we will call our consortium brothers, our Morris brothers, our brothers from all the political factions to take notice of these young men, because that is their homeland. All of them have equal participation with us in the diaspora. So we have to take that into consideration. This struggle is in the diaspora, but this struggle starts in the diaspora, it starts in the homeland, comes to the diaspora, and ends in the homeland when we meet our families there again. So, with that said, we are a people that have the resolve to succeed. Just as we struggled in our various family situations for 55 years, we have still triumphant as one of the most educated people in Africa under such hard circumstances. It's very tough to find a Southern Cameroonian anywhere in the world that cannot intellectually hold his own or her own. That tells a lot of story. That tells that Southern Cameroon, it doesn't matter how we are being brutalized now. It doesn't matter what force is being used against us now. We shall never, ever be crushed to infinity, because we gonna be, and we are, like the phoenix. We shall rise again. And when we rise, we will rise with empathy for all our African brothers and sisters.
Thank you.
So now, where do we go from here? from here is this conference was to explain the position of Southern Cameroon Defense Forces. This conference was not to come and assume leadership of the struggle, because we have fine brothers and sisters in our various political organizations that are doing a great job to lead in the political arena. Military people don't lead politically. We are not prepared to unwillingly create another African dictatorship. We are too educated for that. Anybody who has the intention to come and join the Southern Cameroon Defense Forces with the aim of becoming a strong man in Africa, go look somewhere else. Maybe go to South Sudan. They will take you there. If you come into this military with any political agenda, we will spot you, we will rout you out, and you're going to be expurgated from the military as fast as we can, because we've already done that on the process of being here today. We shall not demonize our brothers by calling names here, but we have expurgated people amongst our ranks because we didn't show faces of these people. We will not call their names either. They were not military people, they were politicians in disguise. So our young people who are interested in politics, we have capable organizations that you can learn the skills from. One was just organized yesterday in New York. Capable brothers in the political arena. Capable brothers in the media arena. We've seen our two brothers, how they revolutionized the struggle with social media and brought awareness to our people in the millions. The genius that they had to rally millions of Cameroonians and non-Cameroonians on social media. I will call the name, Mr. Magbara and Ivo Tapan. I congratulate you all for the work you have, you guys have done. This is when we know that we have brothers that are capable, because before this struggle, we didn't know we have these brothers with this capacity and this intellectual know-how in journalism to be able to galvanize us. And we have our young sisters and brothers who are total political novice, interested in listening to these young brothers, Mr. Mark and Mr. Tapa, talk politics. Before 3 months ago, these young people were not interested in anything politics. They were interested about their discotheque and nightclubs, about what type of dress they are wearing, and what type of shoes they're going to post on Facebook to show how good they are living. But today, all of them are captivated by these two young brothers of ours. That is why, if I was in the position to give an award, I will give the award of best journalist in this whole world to these our two brothers. So, in my own self, as a Southern Cameroonian, I recognize them as the spokespersons for our struggle. Because they have proven that they have the capacity. These two brothers are not just for one particular faction. These two brothers are for every single Southern Cameroonian faction and people. So I will commend them, and I will want them to continue bringing information to all our people, and let nobody tie them to any particular organization, because they are bigger than that. So with that said, I am willing to do my own part, and everybody already know I carry a big gun, yes. So my part is to what? Free Southern Cameroon. My part is to what? Give the young people who will come and see me privately the ability to get the best training in military strategies on how to